Hello from Chris Auchinvole in Wellington. Getting ready though at the end of the week to go down into the electorate, flying straight from Wellington down to Westport, where I'm having an interesting meeting at Westport Motor Hotel, I think it is, and we'll be talking about the Lyle ghost trial. This is one of the proposals that's under the cycle track arrangement, and they've gone through phase one. They'll now be practicing for phase two, or sort of putting forward phase two, and it's going to be a very interesting day. It's quite good when you go to a community like Westport. They know I'm coming, so we've got a whole load of meetings stacked up both sides of the Lyle meeting. So looking forward to that. Then I'll drive down to Moana. It's an hour and a half away, and eventually get home for the weekend. And this weekend, it's quite a busy one. On the Saturday, we've got the Minister of Conservation, Kate Shepherd. She's coming across to open the Brunner Mine, or the Brunnerton Mine. It's a very interesting thing. The Brunnerton Mine was where there was a mine disaster. A lot of people were killed, but they really spruced it up, made it look very attractive. DOC has done that as part of their contribution of DOC Estate Tourism. And it'll be a big gala day to open that, and there's a walkway bridge over the Grey River, and all the mines are actually underneath the river, all around the Dobson area. So it's very interesting. The interesting thing to me is that we value mines from an historical perspective, but we seem not to value mines from an economic perspective at the moment. At least, if you just look at the public demonstrations, that's the impression you'd be left with. The reality is, especially on the West Coast, we do value mines as an economic generator, and we do value miners for the excellent work they do, especially modern mining. So that's going to be an interesting proposal. We've extended the length of time for that public discussion document. We're getting some really interesting suggestions coming through, or submissions coming through. If you'd like to put in a submission, get in touch with my office, or go to the, I think the website is in the Ministry of Economic Development website, MED website, and the discussion paper is there, and you can put your submission in. Mining and tourism do go together. We have the Oceana Gold Mine and Stockton Plateau Coal Mine. Both of those mines have, I think Stockton had up to 40,000 visitors last year. And it's a good commercial enterprise for tourism. So they do go together. Another thing that's heavily under discussion at the moment on the coast is hydro schemes. We have five under consenting programs at the moment, and people are saying we've got too many. Some quick facts on hydro. The top half of the South Island, that's from North Canterbury through to Marlborough, Nelson, Tasman, and then down the west coast, we only produce 23% of the electricity that we use. Only 23% of the electricity that we use is produced in our territory. In other words, we're dragging power from Lake Coleridge. We pull it over the Alps, and it comes over a mountain called Mount Horrible, and that occasionally bursts into flames after long dry summers in the Alps, and it puts our entire power at risk. Not only that, because it's such a drag and the wires are old, there's a lot of heat loss, and we lose 50% peak times, we lose 50% of the power and transmission. We have a number of schemes. The biggest one is the Mahikanui, and that's quite a controversial one, and that's been consented with a 380-page consideration by the commissioners. There's now been an appeal against that by Forest and Bird, an appeal by DOC. The appeal by DOC is simply they want to see their concerns met in a strengthened way. That's my understanding. And I think there might be another appeal against them as well. We live in a litigious time. We live in a litigious time. There are two schemes at Stockton. They seem to be appealing against each other. The Arnold River, we might have got one more appeal against that. But the thing is, as long as the process is pursued properly, I will support any scheme that gets its consents through. It's unfortunate and it's expensive that we live in such a litigious time where you get claim and counterclaim, but that's the nature of it at the moment, I'm afraid. We have changed the Resource Management Act to make things more streamlined. We've got further changes coming up. In fact, we've got a change coming up through the Local Government Select Committee. We've just received the Local Government 2002 Act Amendment Bill. So we'll be amending the Local Government Bill. It's quite a lot of changes. We only just introduced it to the House. We'll be advertising for submissions on that. And once you see the ads, then you'll know that you can right away get a copy of the bill, see what we intend to do. That's going to be another big piece of legislation designed to create greater clarity, transparency and accountability at council level. And I know it'll be appreciated by councils particularly. It makes their life easier if people understand better what they're doing. Just checking my notes here, I was going to talk about... I went to Federated Farmers the other day on the West Coast. Really good. Federated Farmers meeting. And I said I'd like to talk about my commitment to agriculture, 23 years on the dairy board as an exporter, my commitment to farming on the coast, horticulture in Tasman, and all that sort of thing, to aquaculture. And I would like to talk to them about pigs in pens, about cattle in crates, about 15-year-old drivers, 18-year-old drinkers, all that sort of thing. So I asked the Minister of Agriculture what he'd like me to talk to farmers about, and he said, none of the above, talk to them about the emissions trading scheme. So we did that. I won't give you the whole talk now, but to be quite honest with you, if you look at the needs of foresters, if you look at the counter needs of emitters of carbon, the government has created a very balanced position at the moment. It's a balanced position, and we'll talk to you more about that later on. The big item coming up is the budget. The big item coming up is the budget, and I guess all I can say about that at the moment is to reflect the Minister of Finance, Deputy Prime Minister Bill English's remark, and say that it's going to be a budget for many, not the few. For many, not the few. And I think we'll have another chance to talk to you about the budget after 20th of May. Thanks very much indeed. Give us a call anytime.